expertise in different fields, like in pharmaceutical manufacturing, in research and development, in quality control, in quality assurance, in hospital pharmacy, in community pharmacy, in clinical pharmacy, in CROs, in medical devices, in diagnostics and pharma industry. So this is one of the reason the students pursue, they prefer to go for Master of Pharmaceutical Sciences, which is one of their dream to complete their post-graduation in pharmaceutical sciences, particularly from a better university. But particularly for those students who are not able to clear GPAD examinations, there are other options also. They can go for MBA course, they can go for LLB course, they can go for any other course outside the India, they can go for higher studies in the other countries by clearing GRE and TOEFL examination. That options are also open. So with these remarks, my special thanks to IPGA SF team from Delhi State, and my wishes to all, you know, young students. See, this is the right time. Everybody is at home. Most of the people, they are sitting at home, from home, utilizing their time from home. So like, try to utilize this time of COVID and try to prepare yourself with the guidance of Dr. Gaurav Jain, Mr. Sachin, and Miss Ankita, whatever the views they are going to share, to try to implement them. And I will conclude with simple remarks: stay safe, take care, and please follow the few guidelines like maintaining social distance, maintaining hygiene, maintaining your lifestyle, maintaining dietary control, wearing mask, and increasing your immunity, and overall be positive. Because if you are positive, the things will go in the right direction. So my best wishes to all the young students who are attending this webinar for their bright future ahead, and wish them a grand success. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Nasaji, for the introductory remarks and very positive thinking and guiding the young students for the GPAT examination and other career opportunities. I would also like to thank the student forum, which have been giving us the ideas which are out of the box, new, innovative and very surprising also. This is, I think, the second program which they have organized for the young GPAT seekers, and I have attended the last program in FICCI, which was attended by around 200 BPharm students. It was an eye-opener to me. It was very effective, because when we come out of the we found out that most of the participants who have attended and have followed the guidance given by the GPAT toppers and other experts, they have qualified the GPAT examination with a very high score. So this program is also going to be very effective. All the students are requested to take down whatever advice, whatever tips the experts and the GPAT toppers are giving to you. And as Atul Nasaji has told, that you should stay safe, wear the mask, so take all the precautions. And this is in Delhi and NCR region when we have to be very safe. So stay in your homes. The COVID infection is spreading like anything. So now I would like to invite Dr. Gaurav Kumar Jain. He, from the last 10 years, he is working as an associate professor. Recently, he has joined Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences at Dipsuru University. Earlier, he was associate professor in Jamia Hamdard. And he has done PhD in pharmaceutics and has more than 15 years of teaching experience and has published around 75 research papers. Briefly, I will conclude that he is a effective GPAT trainer and has been doing the GPAT training in from the last, I think, more than 10 years. So I request Dr. Gaurav Kumar Jain to address the audience.
Dr. Gaurav. Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you. First of all, I would like to convey my greetings to Vijay Bhalla sir and Arun Garg sir. And I am privileged that now I am in the same institute. I have joined the same institute. First of all, I would like to convey my greetings to Atul Nasa sir, Vijay Bhalla sir and Arun Garg sir. And I am privileged that I have joined their institutes. Means I have joined recently Dipsuru and all three of them, the IPGA core committee is from Dipsuru only. So I am privileged in that sense. And I would also like to thank IPGA Student Forum of Delhi to speak on this topic, which is very close to my heart. Particularly GPAT, because I have been training students not for the last 5 years, but earlier to that I have been involved in training students for the past 10 years. From 2005 to 2014, I have been involved in training students for GPAT. So I would like to run my presentation. Anyone please present my presentation. Good morning to good afternoon to all of the students who are part of this seminar or presentation. Now, if you see my presentation, the first thing I have put is a question mark alongside tips and strategies. Now, why it is so? Because since the topic of today's presentation is tips and strategies to crack GPAT, but I believe that in such a short span of time, I'm not able to teach you the concepts, but I would rather open up the direction, or I will give you advice or share my experience. This is right also, because if you have asked me like 10 years before or even 6 years before, then I will be saying, okay, there are tips, there are strategies, but with the time, with the experience, I can tell you there are no tips, there are no strategies, because all the students are different. And if students are different, then a single tip or a single strategy won't work. But yeah, there are experiences which we can share and which could be helpful for most of the students. I will start with one of my example. When I used to teach, I remember all the values, all the IR values. I am from pharmaceutics, but I really enjoy teaching analytical chemistry. So I remember all the values of IR, UV, visible spectroscopy, even single value I remember. There is no need to open the book while teaching. I just simply remember all the values. But whenever I have made some mnemonics, every time I used to forget those mnemonics. So it is very interesting, because some of the students will learn through mnemonics, but particularly me, I never remember the mnemonics. So just I want to take an example that every student is different. So tips and strategies are not what we are utilizing. The tips in today's scenario is efforts which you are putting, and strategy is your focus and determination to clear GPAT exam. So with this, I start my presentation. Please change the slide. Come to the next slide. Fine. So the word is clarity. The first thing is, with this diagram, I just want to show that right now in fourth year, just change the next slide, we are not clear. we are not clear that what we want to do. Some of us are sailing in 2-3 ships, want to do MBA, GPAT, want to give interview for the job simultaneously. Fine, so this is not correct. I think, first of all, we should focus what we have to do. If you really want to do GPAT, prepare for it. If you want to go for MBA, prepare for it. But prepare for only one thing, because, you know, I would just like to introduce one more point. Jack of all trades, but master of none. So don't become jack of all trades and master of none, because for GPAT, you are preparing for your master preparation only. So it is like clearing it, you will get admission into the master, and you are not the master. So master of none. So don't make it that situation. You make the situation where you have a clear objective that what you want to do based on... Hello? Am I audible?
Please
right. So you should have clarity. This is again very, very important, because I have been interacting with most of these students. They are preparing for GPAT simultaneously. They want to give MBA exam. So they study for both these subjects, and both these topics are entirely different. So they have different strategies. So don't mix the things. If you want to do marketing, go for MBA. If you want to go for research or higher studies, go for GPAT and study it with full faith. Just change the next slide. Next slide, please. Now, with this image, I just want to show that you are able to see the screen. There are all singers, they are singing, and they have eyes closed. Just change the next slide. This will show you their determination. They are 100% in the thing which they are doing. See, I really believe that GPAT is not a difficult exam. It is just lack of determination, or you can say your association with the subject, which can crack it or which can lead to unsuccessful. So what students do nowadays, they are saying that they are giving GPAT exam, but they are not 100% involved in it. They are giving interviews also, they are preparing for other subjects. So there is lack of determination. So if you inculcate this determination, your focus into your exam, trust me, all of you will easily succeed, because exam is not from the outside. It is what you are studying on daily basis. So the basic thing is that you should be clear what is your objective, and if your objective is GPAT, then you should be related or focused onto it. Just next slide, please. Next slide. Yeah, this is again and third a very important component. This is third but very important component. Believe me, I will again share my experience of stress. See, four of my friends were studying. I don't want to do higher studies. My objective was to complete my bachelor's and then to help my parents into their business. So my father has a sari shop, and he always used to say that you just enjoy your college time, and whenever you want, you just join our shop. So after BPharm, I want to join his shop. But due to, you can say, peer pressure, not exactly the right term, peer pressure, but due to, you can say, four of my best friends are also appearing for GPAT exam. So since they are studying, so I was also studying. So we, all of us five together are studying. So usually we are studying the same thing in the same manner. But I'll tell you, all four of them are into stress. Why they are into stress? Because they want to clear the GPAT. And ultimately, when the result was out of these five, I was the one who cleared the GPAT exam, because I have never thought of clearing it. Now, the thing is not that I have not studied. The thing is that I am not in anxiety state. I am not in stress state. What I have seen over the years that what students are more concerned about what other students are doing. Okay, they are studying for 12 hours, I am only studying for 4 hours. See, there is no competition. Again, each student is different. They have different ability, they have different pace, they have different style. So you have to just adjust your style to the matter, to the GPET content. So feel stress-free. Don't believe that, okay, only 2 months are remaining, only 3 months are remaining. Just be stressful, because what stress do, I will show you next slide. Please, next slide. Next. So stress will make your mind out of order. Next slide, please. So they are all simulated slides. So with slides, I just want to show that what is the state of mind of the students. So when you are more stressed, you are out of, the mind is out of order. And trust me, in the exam, this happens. See, I am not, you can say me biased, but most of this time I have seen the students which are topper, in the subjective exams don't perform well in the GPAT exams. The reason being because, and particularly say, I will be offending here, but particularly girls, if you see the ratio, boys do this exam, GPAT exam, qualified GPAT exam more as compared to girls. The reason being because the panic state, girls comes into the panic state more early. So if one question is wrong, it is in their mind. So what they believe throughout the exam, oh my God, they remember like mom and dads and nani, etc. That, oh, this question is wrong. What I will do? I will be knowing this. See, nothing to matter at all. Nothing to matter. Trust me, if you are confident, getting 50 questions out of 125 is not a big deal. It is in our hands, but we make situation difficult for ourselves. What we do, once we are in panic state, it is all mishappening which is happening. You have seen, particularly you have seen cricket matches. What happens in the last 2 overs or 3 overs? Only panic. The matches change. The winning situations becomes a loser situation because of this panic. And this simply happens in GPAT preparation also. Because once a student start to panic, the things he or she remembers, they are not in a correct order. They'll change the order and they will, because of the panic state, they are just doing wrong and wrong. And this will ultimately leads to unsuccessful GPAT exam. The next slide, please. So this is just a simple photo to represent what happens in panic situation. Instead of studying, we are more focused on what others are doing. We are praying and this. So this is a photo taken from a movie, Three Idiots, which very much resembles that. What is the state of mind? So I believe that first of all, students should be clear what they want to do. They should be involved. It is not like that, okay, I have one friend, he will help me. So they should be involved in whatever they are doing. And the third thing is that there should be no stress or anxiety state. They should take it calmly, because once person is calm, you can take the example of Dhoni, you can take the example of Sehwag and numerous other examples. If you take these examples in the non-panic state, in the calm state, always the performance is better. So you should inculcate your mind state, your thought state into your exam. This is very, very important. At the time of when you are preparing for the exam and at the time when you are giving your exam, at both these times. Next slide, please. Now, a very interesting question, when we should start preparing. Again, this is like the question which is asked by numerous students, when we should start preparing. The question is completely wrong itself, because the day you have taken admission in B form, you have already start preparing for the GPAT exam. GPAT exam is not like you have to prepare something new. It is what you have to just remember from the first day itself. So your syllabus of first year, second year, third year and fourth year is coming into your exam. So you have already started. You have to believe yourself. See, what people think that we don't remember anything. There is no need to remember. We have, all of you have brains. The thing is there in your brain. You have, there is loss of belief. There is no loss of brain or memory. There is loss of belief. Once you believe yourself, trust me, you remember all the things. But we don't believe it. Fine? What we think, we don't remember our first year subjects like unit operation or general pharmacy or microbiology when you are in fourth year. But with my experience, I'll tell you that we remember everything. After giving my my GPAT exam, I was thinking that I am fool that I have wasted my 2 months in studying. Sorry. Because when I saw the paper, I just thought that these are all the things which I remember. Not just I have studied in 2 months, but which I have remembered previously also. The paper was very simple. You have to just apply yourself. You have to just inculcate your feeling, your belief in the paper. See, again, I will tell you, because most of the people will think what sir is saying about belief, sir is not talking about tips and strategies. But I'll tell you, with the experience, all those tips, mnemonics and etc. won't work. In the long run, I have understand that the main thing is your state of mind. Everywhere your belief, your state of mind will work. Not the tips and strategies, because all of you are capable. When you are fourth year, when you are in fourth year presently, so all of you are capable because you have passed your first, second and third year. All of you know about your subjects. All of you know what is important in the subject, what is not important in the subjects, because the important thing already have come in your subjective exams. Yeah, I do believe there are certain things, there are certain management, time management which you can perform, which you can inculcate during your study pattern, which I will discuss later in the later half. But the main thing is the state of mind. I have given you my example because I believe that I don't want to clear the GPAT exam, and ultimately I end up clearing GPAT exam because I am not in a stress state. And this, and I know the topper of my class, the subjective topper of my class, she is very brilliant student, but she was not able to clear GPAT. Why? Because she was in panic state. She used to call me every day that Gaurav, aapka kaisa chal raha hai ye? And I used to study only 2 hours a day, that too for only 2.5 months. Not more than that. Trust me, I am not be fooling everybody. Just 2 hours in the morning and 1 hour revision of what I have studied in 2 hours morning time. Only 3 hours in a day, and that too for 2.5 months. And that not too completely, because I have been saturated after 1 month, so I have taken 5-6 days break and the things are moving slowly because I am not very much interested into the GPAT exam. But once I was giving that exam, I believe that paper is not difficult. I will tell you one more situation when we move to next slide, coming slide. So I will give one more situation to you. Just change the slide. So this is just an example. So I just asked the host to share my presentation with the students. So this is the thing which I have been telling students, you can say 5 years back, that this is one pattern which you can adopt. It covers whole of the syllabus and it is 99-day package. Just move to next slide. Before wasting time on this here, you just have a look on this with my presentation. So if you move slowly, then also in 99 days, so nearly in 3 months, you are able to complete your syllabus. So this is just from like, from 2 to 4 hours per day study package, not more than that. Fine, so you are able to clear your GPAT preparations mostly in 90 to 100 days, not more than that. So there is no need to panic. Still, a lot of time is there. You can easily manage the things. And trust me, I have started studying in the month of October after my educational tour. So we have educational tour to Goa. Then after coming from that tour, I have started studying. We all five started studying after that tour in the month of October. And I have studied October, November, and not in December, but half of January. So our exam was in Feb. So these 2.5 months I have studied, and I have easily cleared GPAT with 72 All India rank. That too with not my 100%, but yeah, 80% or so, and having 98.86 percentile. So when I am not interested in GPAT, still I am able to clear it, then believe me, those all participants which are here today listening to this talk, they will easily qualify because they have a belief, they want to clear the GPAT. So they have one more advantage over me. So they can get good marks, definitely. Next slide, please. Now, the next thing is what to study. Again, I believe that this is a wrong question, because what to study is the thing which you have to decide. See, I have skipped whole pharmacognosy during my GPAT preparation because I am not good at it. This is not because I don't want to study, because I am not good at it. So I believe that with the less time and with the saturation, I just finished my pharmacology, medicinal chemistry, means chemistry part, and pharmaceutics part. So the cognosy part is untouched. But what to study is solely your decision. Nobody can tell you what to study. You have to decide what to study. Everybody knows what is GPAT. Since you are preparing, you have an idea about GPAT pattern, even more than me. So once to keep pattern in your mind, you have to decide what you have to study. You don't take it from others that what you have to study. You decide what you have to study. Every student has different method to study. Don't change your method, because at this time, if you are starting to prepare for GPAT exam, at this time it is very difficult to adjust with new method. Adopt your method and inculcate advice of the others, your seniors or others. Fine, inculcate that advice, inculcate that pattern, but don't change your study concepts. Next slide, please. So again, this is just for reference, because since I am presenting, so I am sharing what my experience is. But you have to take the decision that, okay, I have to study pharmacology, I am good in it. I have to study pharmacology in this manner or in that manner. I have to study pharmaceutics. We can definitely give you advice, not in this particular presentation because time limit is there, but definitely we can advise you. But the decision has to be yours. So based on my experience, this is subject-wise distribution. Usually out of 125 questions, pharmacology has a major part of 40%, 40 questions nearly. So they are all about or near speculations. Pharmaceutics from 35 questions to 40 questions. Chemistry cover 20 to 25 questions. And similarly, pharmacognosy covers 20 to 25 questions. Next slide, please. The detail, the subject-wise detail, I have shown in next slide. So, in the pharmacognosy, the biotech or industrial part has 7 questions nearly. Again, all these are based on like last 10-year question papers. The specific or microscopy part covers 8 to 10 questions. And basic pharmacognosy, which includes name of the drugs, the other name of the drugs, or their genera, etc., covers 8 to 10 questions. The inorganic chemistry covers 5 questions. Again, they are about 5 questions. The organic chemistry covers 8 to 10 questions, and medicinal chemistry covers 8 to 10 questions. The most of the important part is biopharmaceutics and pharmaceutical technology, which has 15 to 20 questions in their bucket. So these two subjects are very, very important. The physical pharmacy of second year and formulative of third year, along with regulatory affairs. So the topics of your M-Form, the few topics of your M-Form, which covers in regulatory affairs. So they are total 8 to 10 questions. The general pharmacy, or also called as pharmaceutics 1, along with unit operation, your microbiology and jurisprudence. In total, there are 8 to 10 questions from all these topics. Your biochemistry, your clinical pharmacology, and specific pharmacology, so you can say tough questions of pharmacology, will occupy 12 to 15 questions. The general pharmacology, these direct questions, they are again 8 to 10 questions. And the side questions based on side effects and uses from the pharmacology are again 8 to 10. So in total, this is distribution of 125 questions. If you can see the pattern, out of 125 questions, 70 or 75 questions are straightforward. So if you just believe, or if you just think calmly, you are able to attempt 70 to 75 questions. But I know there are problems which I will discuss in subsequent slides. So why we are not performing well? So just change the next slide. So the main thing again, I will say again, the because I like this movie. So this is expert from the movie Three Idiots. Kabil bano, kamyabi jhak maar ke. आएगी आपके पास, पीछे आएगी. Fine. So the main thing is you have to just study whatever you want to study of the particularly of the subject. You study that. Definitely, if you are giving your 100%, the success will come to you. Next slide, please. Smart study. The few things I have already told to you that. The study in a smart manner. A smart manner does not mean cheating, particularly. Fine. So cheating is not there in a smart manner, but a smart study is a well time managed study. So the main thing is people are not able to manage their time. So here I am not focusing on the subject. I am not focusing on how the tips or strategies. I am focusing on time management, because at the end we end up losing one whole subject or whole one topic. We are not able to cover that. So you have to manage your time. You have to devote or distribute your time that, okay, I want to study pharmacology for 1 month, then 1 month pharmaceutics, and then half month pharmacognosy, and you will see that there is no time left after that. So you have to manage this whole lot of time with among yourself. Next slide, please. So don't lose hope. Again, this is very, very, very important, because the panic state, or the when you lose your hope, you start to tumble in the exam also. Again, I want to share my experience. So in my time, it was not online test, it was offline test. 30 questions are of 1 marks, then remaining 60 questions are of 2 marks. So total test is of for 150 marks. So when I start doing 30 questions, which are of 1 marks, believe me, starting 20 questions, I don't know 18 questions. Most of them are from pharmacognosy. And since I have not studied pharmacognosy, so 18 questions out of first 20 questions, I am not able to attempt. Fine. But at that time, what I believe that I am not here to clear GPAT. So this is there in the back of my mind, because I've always wanted to join my family business. So I have this thing clear in my mind that, see, it is not necessary for me to clear the GPAT. And particularly this feeling generated hope in me. I have not lost my hope. And at the end, I end up with securing 127 marks out of 150. Even I have not attempted those 18 questions which are there in the starting 20 questions. I am able to clear 127. I am able to get 127 marks out of 150 marks. Fine. So this is basically because of the state of mind. I have never lost hope. I just wanted to clear GPAT for my satisfaction. Not that I want to go for higher studies, but just for my satisfaction. So your belief, your satisfaction, your never-ending fight is very, very important throughout your GPAT preparation as well as during your examination also. See, in exam, state of mind plays a vital role. Trust me, it plays a vital role. Next slide, please. Next slide. So here are few examples which I want to take, which can tell you that without knowing anything, you can attempt several questions. So if you just go through the question, you can see the question is there. So still, I remember because this is from pharmaceutics, so I remember the equation. But suppose you are not remembering the equation, still you are able to attempt this, because in this question one important word is there, word that is zero order kinetics, and there is no need to apply an equation, because if you see all the results, all the choices, only one choice, which is the A choice, has the same units which are for zero order kinetics. So based on the units, this answer you can attempt. Just next, please. Next slide. Just change the slides. Next slide. Again, just skip this slide. Next slide, please. Again, this is same. I just want to say that even if, just I'll again take an example, if you see that the drug concentration was 2.5 microgram, after 4 hours it is 1.89, so loss in the drug concentration is about 0.6, and you have to determine the half-life is from 2.5 to 1.25, so loss is nearly 1.25, so loss is of 1.25. And you can see 0.6 microgram per ml concentration loss is there in 4 hours. So 1.25 should be in double the time, 4 hours plus slightly more than 4 hours. So it should be close to 9 hours. So without knowing any equation, if you can see the choice in the 83rd question, you can see 9.91 hours. So this is the answer, because no other value is close to 8 or 9. So this is the answer. And if this is the time, and you just simply know that K elimination for first order process is 0.693 divided by T, and T is nearly 10 hours, so the answer will be choice A. So without knowing any equation, nothing, you can attempt several questions. The main thing is you have to not lose the hope. Again, next slide, please. I'm just giving these examples in order, because people say that we don't know this question, I don't remember, but I am saying without remembering anything, without applying anything, you can solve certain questions. And these few 5 to 10 questions play a vital role. One more important thing, all these questions I have taken from a single paper. This is paper from 2008. You can just check, because I have put the questions also, all these question numbers also. So all these questions are there in 2008 GPAT question paper. Now, in this slide, if you see that this is multiple type question. So if you don't remember all the choices, suppose you remember only about calamine. And calamine, you know that it is an ore, contains zinc oxide with a small amount of ferric oxide. So by going through all the four, you feel that you don't know about kaolin, about kieselguhr, about talc, but just you remember about calamine. So R, and you know that it is 4. So if you see the answers, fine. So R with fourth choice is only one option, that is C option. So I am saying that there is nothing to lose the hope, because you can attain your questions without having a limited knowledge also at times. So here if you see, choice A has RS3, B has RS1 and D has RS1. So ultimately, knowing only one calamine, you can attempt this question. Just change the slide. Come to next slide. Again, change this, because this is same. Knowing that sodium chloride has a role in IR spectrometry, so P4, only one choice is there. You can attempt this question also. Again, I have not changed any answer. Nothing I have changed. This is the true question I have picked up from 2008 GPAT paper. Next slide, please. Again, next, this is same Noyes-Whitney equation. If you know, it is P1. Again, direct answer is there. Now, this is one more example. Since it is different, so I am taking this up. So this is medicinal chemistry, and trust me, right now I don't know about medicinal chemistry. So yesterday when I am trying to solve few questions with these strategies and tips, I tried this question and I am able to solve it without knowing any medicinal chemistry. You see, there is X, then there is a structure plus NH3 will give you nifedipine. You just count number of carbons. Just come to next slide. Their number of carbons are there. Fine. If you see in first slide, the number of carbons are 7. And in the resultant, means in the product which is formed, the number of carbons are 17. Fine. So nothing else is left. Only there is a difference of 10 carbon. Fine. Now, if you see the reagent X, because you have to determine the X, the A choice has 5 carbons. Then there is B choice with, I suppose, 4 carbons. Then there is C choice with 3 carbons and D choice again with 3 carbons. Sorry, C choice with 4 carbons and D choice with 3 carbons. So if you see that 10 carbons only can be attained with reagent A, if you are using 2 molecules of reagent A, so 2 into 5 is 10. Fine, just move to next slide. And this is the answer. So by reacting it, you can see that the answer is A choice, where the total number of carbons is same as that of result and product. So you can again cross check it by counting the numbers of nitrogen, counting the number of hydrogen as well. So I am saying that with a particular question, you do not lose your hope. You try to solve it, apply your brains on that question, and trust me, plus 5 or plus 10 questions you are able to attempt. Now, this slide, stop being greedy. This is again very, very important, because for most of the students, I realize that they are able to attempt 50 to 70 questions. Most of the students, they are able to attempt 50 to 70 questions. So they are able to qualify GPAT, because for GPAT, I believe that 35 to 40 correct questions are required. But what happens? They end up not qualifying because of their greedy behavior. Now, how this greedy behavior comes? This greedy behavior comes that to gain more and more marks, to gain position. So your first step should be to qualify GPAT exam, not to come first or second, that you will eventually come. But what we do, suppose we are attempting 50 questions. Now we are certain that, okay, I will qualify GPAT. Now I become greedy to get rank also, to get good rank also. So what I do, I attempt more and more questions. Now, few questions I am attempting without knowing the answer. What I calculate at that moment, I will calculate, okay, 4 questions I will attempt. If one of them is correct, then if 3 is incorrect also, I will lose nothing. But many times this happens, then that when you are attempting like 100, like out of 125, 100 questions or 110 questions, you end up not qualifying the GPAT. Because of this greedy, because of the negative 1 mark, you start losing the marks. So if you are getting 200 marks out of 50 questions, then 50 incorrect questions will result in ending up at 150 marks, and this could result in not qualifying the GPAT. So this is the problem I am observing in the present students, that they try to attempt more and more questions, which based on my experience, I feel is not the good choice. I think you first see that how many questions you are attempting. So my guru mantra is that you, if you are able to attempt 20 to 30 correct questions, then you try to being greedy. But if you are able to attempt 50 correct questions, then don't be greedy. If you have 100%, 100% this answer is right, then go for it. If there is any doubt, then leave the question. Yeah, but conversely, if you have only attempted 30 questions, so you are at borderline, in that case, you can take chance to attempt certain undoubtful or doubtful questions in that case. But if you are, you have attempted 50 correct questions, then my advice is that don't take risk after that, because you will be qualified. Certainly you will be qualified at 200 marks with certainly good position. So they don't be greedy at that moment and try to believe yourself. If you know more questions, 100% attempt it. If you don't know, if you have a doubt, move it, remove it. Fine. So next slide, please. Next slide, please. You just leave this slide, because these are some notes which I have prepared when I used to give coaching. So you can take help of those notes. I can provide these notes to all the students who are participants through mail to them. Again, this is website which I have prepared. So this is entirely free of cost to all the participants, to all the students. So you register yourself, you select MCQ practice pack, you add my free account as promo code, so your fee will be waived off, and then you are able to customize your online test. In this website, the tests are given in topics, topic based tests are there. So you can select like unit operation topic. In unit operation, you can select filtration, fine, clarification. So topic wise questions are there. Suppose today I am preparing for two topics. One is filtration and the second one is antihistaminics. So you can select these two topics from the online test and you can give test on that. The questions are always random. They are non-repetitive. So it has a bank of nearly 10,000 questions, which are more than enough. And most of the questions are based on the experience. So they will certainly help you to qualify GPAT. Fine. So this is free of cost for all the participants or for all the students. You have to just register and you have to use the promo code My Free Account. Next slide, please. So with this, I would like to thank all the listeners. I would like to thank IPGA Core Committee to give me chance to speak on this topic. This is the topic where I can speak non-endingly, because when I used to take class, I can take class for 6 hours or 7 hours continuously. Fine, because I am very fond of advising or teaching students on this topic, because I have never prepared for this exam. But this exam has entirely changed the way of my life, the fate of my life. I have thought of ending up as a business person at my shop, but I ended up as a teacher because of this exam. So anytime any person need advice or help, I am there with my mobile number and email ID. And I just wish you all the best for your future. I'm ready to take up any questions if there are. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Gaurav, and I think you have given a very valuable advice to the students.